Sorry, Stroke. I've never heard of the band.
What do you mean you never heard of them? You've heard of R.E.M., Red Hot Chili Peppers, Dead Kennedys?
Sure, but that's not who you're bringing up.
No, but Open Wound is open for them, and that's very respectable off the mainline arenas, too.
Now, why aren't people buying tickets?
Maybe because no one's ever heard of the band.
What about you and Linda? I could slide you some tickets to cost.
With Linda's schedule, the pilgrim nights are tough.
That guy sounds so hot.
Excuse me.
Just a bunch of jokes. What's the Jewish-American princess idea of a perfect house?
I don't know what.
4,000 square feet.
No kitchen, no bedroom. I can't believe somebody wrote this. Let me see. It's disgusting. I've read all these. They're boring.
Well, who wrote it?
Who wrote what?
Someone's idea of humor.
Yeah? The care and feeding of a Havenhurst Jap.
Favorite wine?
Wait, I know that one. I know that one.
I want to go to Miami.
You guys are laughing at that? Wait, you don't find anything offensive in it?
What? Look, lighten up.
Whitney, it degrades women. It's anti-Semitic.
It's called humor, Patty. It's just a joke.
Oh,
well, we're getting big laughs at this table.
Well, maybe no one at this table's got a sense of humor. What's the big deal? People make Polish jokes and preppy jokes all the time.
And don't forget the ones about dumb blondes.
Oh, I especially like those.
See what I mean?
Exactly.
Well, Morrissey, you wouldn't care if I made jokes about Irish Catholics, would you?
No, go ahead, let's see.
See what I mean?
Whoa. Jessica, you're Jewish. Is this stuff, does it bother you?
My roommate from outside the key with the right touch, as usual.
I'm asking.
Whitney, I must have heard them all by the time I was 12. They all start sounding alike. All those jokes about being spoiled brat, close to daddy, liking money, not liking sex. People who make jokes like that, that's their problem.
Joke?
I don't consider degrading women funny.
You don't have to. There's such a thing as freedom of speech, you know.
Well, bigots always hide behind free speech.
I'm signing your petition. Great. Put down your dorm room, too, in case we organize a rally. How about you?
No, I don't think so.
What, you think it's all right that they can publish a pamphlet like this?
I don't know if you're Jewish.
I'm just not a signer, all right?
Come on, Patty.
Thanks.
Like
fun.
Hey, Jess.
What's wrong?
I don't know what this is.
Oh, come on. Will you just, like, quit complaining? You said you were going to break even, right?
I'm not in business to break even. Well, what about you and Janet? couple third row centers.
Look, that's not our kind of music, Stroke.
Try it. If you want, you can resell my ticket. I mean, I'm not sure where I'm going tonight. Delta House?
Huh? You getting to be a regular down there.
Check on my ticket sellers over at the union.
All right, later, Stroke.
I came by for those houses. Are not sent on you?
Oh, yeah. This will take me a couple hours to find them here. Did you go by the Los Angeles block?
Yeah.
Did you see that demonstration going on about that flyer that we read for breakfast yesterday?
I didn't pay much attention. Look, if you can't find it, I can go back.
No, they're here. No, where I come from, people make jokes about blacks and Italians and, you know, the whole thing, but I guess I kind of thought I left that humor on the other side of the Hudson. What?
You. I mean, the way you think Havenhurst is. I don't know, the ivory tower, the promised land, none of the problems of the real world.
I've got another theory.
You usually do.
I think people make jokes about things they're afraid of, things that are different. I mean, different from themselves, race, religion, different from them.
People have their own prejudices, and they're ignorant. I don't need to psychoanalyze that or confront it. It's their problem.
Ah-ha. There they are.
Great. Thanks.
I've got another theory.
I don't want to hear it.
I think you're just like me. I think you came to Havenhurst, and you don't think those prejudices can touch you.
Oh, I'm just like you, huh?
Yeah, in some ways.
Bet you didn't think I noticed that jacket.
Well, it's a jacket.
Is it new?
Yeah.
Get up.
No.
Get up.
Look, I'm not saying we sit on our hands and just look the other way. We have to make every effort to find the authors of this stuff. Chances are they'll be involved in something like this again.
I only wish this was about a couple of kids and a copy machine.
Well, once we trace this to who's ever responsible, we expose them. It's the beginning. It's something that goes deeper than that. How long ago was it that colleges like this had admissions quotas? And I'm not talking about affirmative action. I'm talking about quotas to keep people out.
Not that long ago.
Trying to do something. We're already ahead of the last dean.
The university always has two natures. On the one hand, it is our safe haven, a world apart, like Shakespeare's green world, or that place that Baudelaire described, which is all beauty and order, full, rich, and calm. But on the other hand, the university is also part of us. And our life here on campus reflects society's troubles. I'm sure you're all aware of this pamphlet entitled The Care and Feeding of the Havenhurst Jap. So today, I propose that we put aside our books and we discuss this in an open forum.
Professor Hauser.
Yes?
Well, I think Lyra's very important, but I think a lot of us were confused about what you said the other day. About how the history of nationalism and capitalism are really the same thing.
But, Miss Cohen...
We were hoping, at least I was, that you would discuss that today.
I will, in the next lecture. Today, I want to use this to discuss some issues that are very relevant to our study of history, the politics of tolerance and free expression, the role of humor as propaganda.
That's what it is, propaganda.
Right. Just the drawing on the cover. It's supposed to be funny, but it represents a stereotype.
Mr. Morrissey?
No, I just remember when I was a kid and Russia was supposed to be our enemy, that they had these posters and the Russian people were like dressed up kind of like bears with these huge, enormous claws.
So humor can be used to influence opinion. Political cartoonists do it every day.
Can anyone tell me how that works?
It's like when something's repeated over and over, like a joke, people begin to believe it.
Under Hitler, that was called the big lie.
Yeah, and all that stuff about the concentration camps and how they supposedly murdered 6 million Jews.
Supposedly? What do you mean?
Well, it couldn't have been 6 million. Not even close. I mean, the ovens couldn't even handle that many.
How could you say something like that?
True, Jessica. My father showed me this book. Of course, that's not the point. I mean, even one Jew would be too many, but still.
No, there's so much proof. Thousands of people who remember. How can you deny that? I think we're changing the subject.
Well. All right, what about the First Amendment?
Are you sure?
Yeah, he's the one I got a good look at.
Ted Revell. Delta House.
Delta? I thought Delta was a good house.
That depends on your definition of good. Do they break windows and throw beer kegs into the street? No. Do they discriminate against minorities? Some of us think so.
Isn't that illegal?
Not if it's an unwritten, unspoken policy. You take a look. Besides, they usually pledge a few token minorities just to keep us off their back.
And what about Ted Rizal?
It doesn't sound familiar. I don't think there's record of anything on him.
There is now.
So you've decided to file a charge and bring this up before the J Board?
Yeah.
I need to warn you about this. He and his friends, they're going to say they were just walking behind you, telling jokes. I can tell you that's the way it's going to go.
I know.
And you still want to go ahead?
I was attacked because of my religion. I'm Jewish. I won't accept that. He can answer my charges any way he likes.
Jess, you been to the dean?
Yeah. She showed me pictures of all the upperclassmen.
Look, it'd be freshmen.
No.
You know who they are?
One.
Oh, yeah?
I can only identify one.
Uh-huh.
Actually, it's funny or not so funny.
What is?
You told me about
Laval? Laval Publishing?
Ted?
Yeah.
What I do with this? I go to Sinclair.
The Sinclair for what?
Sinclair, he'll wreck Rebel. Jay Hunt thrown out of the house. I know him. You'll see.
You don't get it.
How's that?
Delta is a restricted house.
But they have minority brothers.
That doesn't mean anything.
Oh, yeah? Well, we'll see.
Next Tuesday, Maddie gets her first big break.
The director decided that I was perfect for film.
There's just one catch.
The one he did last year, Paul Newton.
Frontal side.